So let's talk manometers. The last time I've talked about yung manometry natin, differential manometers where the ends are closed. So ito, piezometers. Okay, let us recall yung ating topic. So in a piezometer, it is consisting of a glass tube connected to a vessel or a pipe at which a static pressure is to be measured. Kaya lang yung measurement mo dito is in terms of the column of the fluid dyan, or the liquid column. Sir, saan karaniwan nakalagay yung liquid column na yan? So yung liquid column, it is mostly placed at the bottom of the tank. Bakit sir? Diba sabi natin that pressure is equal to the specific weight of your fluid multiplied to the height column of the fluid. Diba? Ito yung general formula natin for the hydrostatic pressure. Okay? Now, diba ang pressure natin, pwede naman yung pipe natin or even the container can contain any fluid given there. So, sir, pwede palang i-multiply ko ito. Expand ko yung iyong equation. So, SG of the fluid, the specific gravity of the fluid multiplied to the relative density of the fluid, which is yung sa water. And then, you multiply it with the height column of the fluid. Sir, sabi mo that the piezometer is consisting of a glass tube that is connected to the vessel, where that glass tube is showing you the height column of the fluid. Then therefore, we can say na yung height column of the fluid is equal to the pressure of the fluid or the pressure inside the tank or the piping multiplied to divided by the specific gravity of the fluid divided by yung density of the water. For general formula, that is pressure divided by specific weight of any fluid that is contained under the container. Okay? Eh sir, pwede rin palang ang piezometer natin pinagpatong-patong na fluid where the fluids are immiscible. Ano yung immiscible? They can never what? They can never mix with each other like water and oil. Diba? Water and oil will not and will never ever, okay, by theory, mix with each other unless lagyan mo ng temperature. Okay? At room temperature or standard temperature and pressure, water and oil will never be miscible with each other. So, pwedeng yung nasa taas yung oil and nasa baba yung water. Whichever is denser, siya yung nasa baba ng tanke. Okay? So, ang mangyayari dyan, at the top of the tank, up to their meniscus, kung saan sila nag-join, we can say that different ang pressure nun. And the deeper the depths of your tank containing the fluid, the higher the pressure there will be. Okay? Oh, yan yung gagawin natin ngayon. So, for piezometry. Okay? So, let us go with the piezometers. Okay. I have here a sample, a certain example of your piezometer. Okay? So, dito, mayroon kang given na tank dyan. Okay? So, the tank shown in the figure contains three different fluids. Okay? Liquid A, B, and C, which specific gravities vary from each other. At respectively, 0.8, 1, and 13.6. What will be the pressure at the bottom of the tank if the liquid surface are as the elevation shown? Okay? No matter, tandaan nyo, no matter if the fluid container is slanted or whatever the, whatever its, tawag dito, orientation is, okay? Yung pressure niya will be the same. Habang bumababa ka dyan, mayroon kang pressure. Okay? May pressure ka dyan. Okay? Oh, yung pressure na dito, yung pressure ng 3, okay, and 4. Yung pressure niya dito sa baba na ito at this 1, this is pressure at 3 or 2 to 3. And then, yung pressure niya dito is from 1 Totoo. Okay, iba-iba yung pressure niyan. Now, at different SGs, iba-iba rin yung elevation nila. So, we can say, we can have their separate pressures with each other. Okay? So, this is part A, part B, part C. Yan. You sectionize the system. Now, this is open to, tandaan nyo, this is open to the atmosphere. Okay? So, at A, yan, yung pressure at 3 and 4. This is open to the atmosphere. So, this is 0. Equal to, okay? Yung density ng A and then height column at A. Where, yung height column at A is here. Dito yung HA. HB. HC. Ayan. Okay? Now, yun yung first equation mo. You want to know the pressure at 2. So, P2 minus P3 is equal to density ng B and then height column of B. Ngayon, meron kang P3 dito, di ba? So, P3 equal to density ng A, HA. Ayan, ganyan lang yung pag-embody ng kanyang equation. So, ipasok mo dito yung equation ni A, ni P3. So, P2 is equal to P3 plus density ni B, HB. Where your P3 is this one. So, equal pa rin yan ng density ni A, HA, plus density ni B, HB. Okay? Dito tayo nagsimula at top to bottom. So, ito yung at B. At C. Ano yung at C? P1 and then P2. Saan yun? P1 and P2. Nandun, no? Sa baba, oh. P1 and P2. Nandito tayo sa part na ito. Okay? So, this will become density ni C, H ni C. Oh. Yung P2, saan natin makukuha? Eh, ito yan, oh. Diba? So, i-reform natin. P1 will be equal to, P1 is the bottomest pressure. That is the pressure at the bottom of your tank. So, P2, density ni C, HC plus, okay? Equal yan, ipasok mo na ito. Density ni A, HA plus density ni B, HB plus density ni C, HC. So, this will become P1. Ayan na yung at bottom of the tank. Okay? That is the bottom of the tank. Eh, how about, sir, kung gusto ko from top to bottom, ganun din ang gagawin mo. Kaya lang, mas maigi kasi na sa bottom ka magmumula. Okay? So, let us solve. If the bottom pressure at P1 is equal to density ni A, HA, plus density ni B, HB, plus density ni C, HC. Kaya lang, recall mo that the specific weight pala to, hindi density. Specific weight of any material, any fluid, is equal to yung SG of the fluid multiplied to the density of water. So, the common factor there is the density of water. We can factor it out. So, P1 is equal to density in water. Okay. Density in water is, yan, labas natin. SG ni A, height column ni A, plus SG ni B, height column ni B, plus SG ni C, height column ni C. We can now know the pressure at the bottom of the tank. Okay. So, what is the pressure at the bottom? It could be PSI. O, mas gusto ko na to. 62.4. O, density ng water yan. Pound per feet cube. O, multiply ko na kagad to ng 1 feet. Ano ba siya? Naka-meter? Oh, meter, gawin ko na lang 9.81. Ay, 9.81 na lang siya. So, this will become 9.81 kilonewton per cubic meter. SGA. Ano yung SGA? Ano yung SG niya? That is 0.8. 0.8. Tapos, height column ni A, follow nyo dito, sa taas, 3 meters. Plus, 1. And the height column ni B, that is 1.8. Plus, height column ni C, that is 1.2. And then 13. 1.2 meters. Oh, meron tayong meters. Meters, kilonewton meter, that is kPa. Okay? So, solve natin siya. 0.8 times 3 plus 1.8 plus 13.6 times 1.2. Total na yan, ha? And then, i-multiply mo dun sa 9.81. That is the pressure at the bottom of the tank. 2.1. Sa 2.1312 kPa. Okay? Sir, eh meron tayong tinatanong diyan. How about the height columns? You want to solve the height columns? You just divide it with the respective ano nila? Respective SGs and then densities. Okay? Yan yung height columns nila. How about pressure at 2? P2. Simple lang yan, P2 mo dyan. Yung P2 is density ni A. Ito, yung part na to. 9.81 kilonewton per cubic meter multiplied to 0.8 tapos 3 meters plus 1 multiplied to 1.8 meters. Ayan. So, pwede natin ma-solve na agad yan. Makikita nyo siya na habang tumataas ka naman dun sa tanke mo, bumababa yung pressure. Okay? So, 0.8 times 3 plus 1.8. That is 21.5 times 9.81. Di 21.5 yun. 21 divided by 5. So, this is 41.202 kilonewton per meter cube. A meter squared. Oh, that is kPa pa rin. How about P3? Oh, P3 naman. Solve natin. Oh, yung P3, nasa taas lang yan. Oh. Yung sa A. Oh, HA, 3. So, 9.81 multiplied to kilonewton per cubic meter. You multiply it with 0.8 times 3 meters. Oh, mataas na, mababa na yung pressure niyan. Okay? So, 0.8 times 3 times 9.81. Okay. The pressure is 23.544. kPa. Sa taas, that is atmospheric, open to the atmosphere. Okay? So, ganun po yung proper solving of your piezometer. Okay? Did you get it? Class, did you get it? So, let me take a pause. So, let us continue our discussion. So, I have a tip here. Para hindi kayo nalilito pagdating ng piezometer, the first thing to do is this step. So, at step 1, okay, step 1 nyo, get the individual specific weights. Yan, ilista nyo yan. Step 2. Is you get the individual pleasures. And after getting the individual pleasures, that is the time for you to get the height columns. Okay? You solve now for the height column of the piezometer depending on the fluid na ginamit nyo dyan sa height columns nyo. Yeah. So, at first, isolve ko muna yung kanyang mga specific weights. Okay? Ano ba tinatanong dyan? Meron tayong 3 liquids here in the container as shown. And then, they have specific gravities of 0.81 and 1.60 respectively. With the liquid surfaces at the elevation shown, what is the pressure in PSI in the bottom of the tank? At what elevation will the liquid stand each piezometer tubes? Yung mayroong height column at A, B, and C. Okay? Pwede rin kasing iba yung nandito sa height column mo. Ibang liquid yung nakalagay dyan. Other than the fluid na meron ka dito sa tanke. Okay? So, what is the pressure at 0.1 to 4? Hanapin muna natin yung specific weights of each fluid. Okay? Oh, specific weight ni A. That is SG ng fluid A, height column ni A. Pagpalagay natin, ayan na. Ano yung height column ng A? Ay, mali pala. SGA and then, in the height column ni A yan, sorry. Specific weight ni water. So, water muna, 62.4 pound per cubic foot. Multiply mo SG ni A, 0.8. This will become 62.4 times 0.8. So, 49.92 pound per feet cube. Oh, ano yan? Specific weight naman ni B. SG ni B. Specific weight ng water. This is 62.4, yung specific weight ni water, okay, pound per feet cube, multiply mo sa 1. Or this will become 62.4 pound per feet cube. Okay. Specific weight ni C, SGC. Specific weight in water equal to yung kay C, that is 1.6 times 62.4 pound per feet cube. Okay? Multiply na natin to. 0.8, bali, times 2 ko na lang to. This will become 99.84 pound per feet cube. Ayan. Tapos na tayo dun sa kanyang specific weights. Then we go with the pressures, individual pressures. Now, magsimula tayo dito sa taas. Okay? For individual pressures. Individual pressures. Individual pressures. Now, copy ko ulit to para hindi ka nalilito. Yan, individual pressures. Yung pressure niya at this point. Okay? Yung pressure niya at this point and this point. So, let us take yung pressure 1 to pressure 2. Okay? That is equal to density ni A, height column ni A. Okay? Where yung pressure 1 mo dyan, okay, is, add mo to, baliktarin ko ha, 2 to 1. Okay, 2 to 1. Pressure 2 to 1. Pressure 2 to 1, paakyat. Pressure 2 to 1. Ito, it is atmospheric 0 eh. O, kaya 0 siya. 0. So, P2 will become density ni A, HA. Okay. P2, pwede mo na may compute yung P2 dyan. So, that is density ni A. May nakuha mo dito. That is 49.92. 49.92 pound per feet cube. Yung height column dyan is in feet. Okay? Yan o. 9 feet. Times 9 feet. And then multiply ko nung conversion factor nito. You have 1 feet squared every 144 inch squared. Para lalabas dito is in PSI. So, 49.92 times 9 times 144. Divide ko ng 144. 144. That is 3.12 PSI. Yeah. How about yung sa P2 and A3? P3 to P2 equal to height column ni B at saka density ni B. So, this will become, lipat ko dito. So, P3 is equal to P2 plus ito yung density ni B, HB. Okay. Now, this is 3.12 PSI plus, okay, density ni B, that is 62.4. 62.4 pound per feet cube. Ano naman yung height column niya dyan sa part B? That is 10 inch. 10 feet yan, 10 feet. 10 feet. And then multiply mo ng 144. 1 feet squared per 144 inch squared. So, this will become 62.4 times 10. Divide mo ng 144. This is 4.333. Okay? Add mo pa. 3.12. So, ang kanyang pressure at that point is 7.45. 7.453 PSI. How about P4 to 3? That is, meron ka ng P3. Density ni A, ni C, height column ni C. Okay? So, P4 is equal to P3 plus density ni C, height column ni C. So, P3 is 7.453 PSI plus, yung nakuha mo kay C, that is 99.84 pound per feet cube. Tapos, ano yung height column dyan? Yung height of fall, that is 8 feet. 8 feet. Multiplied to 1 feet squared per 144 inch squared. Ano yung magiging pressure at the bottom? So, add ko na to. Add. Okay. 99.84 plus 8. Plus 8. Multiplied to 8. Divide by 144. So, the answer is 13 PSI. Okay, that is 13 PSI. Now, I just want to get the height column na mame-measure mo sa answer. Oh, I just want to get the height columns na mame-measure mo dito sa iyong piezometers. Ayan. Ano yung height columns na meron ka dyan per fluid? So, nakuha mo na yung, iba kasi yung pressure nito, this one, sa dulo. Okay? Habang mababa ka. Ano yung certain fluid na gagamitin mo dyan? We say, meron ka dyan na certain fluid. Okay? Height column at A. You want to get the height column at A. That is, yung pressure at A divided by density at A. Okay? So, ano ba yung pressure at A? That is 3.12 PSI. Okay? Pounds per square inch to. Ganyan mo. Pound per inch squared. You have to multiply it with 144 inch squared per 1 feet squared. Sir, SOP na to ha. Gagawin nyo na kagad yan para ma-convert yung PSI into feet squared. Kasi ang susunod dyan, dapat magiging feet yan. So, ano nakuha mo sa density at A to recall? Naandun sa taas. That is 49.92. 49.92. Ano to? Density pound per feet cube. Cancel natin yung same units. In squared, pound, pound, feet. May matirang isa. Cancel to. So, ang ating height column in feet is 3.12. Times 144 divided by 49.92. That is 9. Check nyo. 9 feet. Correct ba yung 9 feet? Ayun o. Sakto. 9 feet o. Check. That is for checking. How about the height column at B? Tignan nyo natin kung tatama siya. Pressure at B. Okay? Pressure at B ba yan? Ha? Yes, pressure at B yan. Divide by yung kay B. That is 7.453 pound per inch squared. Multiply mo na agad ng 144 inch squared per feet squared. Divide by yung density at B. That is 62.4 pound per feet cube. Canceling the same unit, may tirang isa. Ito, 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 ito. So, the answer will be 7.453 times 144 divided by 62.4. So, that is 17.19 feet. Sir, mali yan. Tama yan. Kasi habang lumalalim kayong height column na i-measure mo dyan, tamang-tama, hindi yan naabot dito sa dulo. Okay? That is 17.19 feet. HC, P, C. Tapos density at C. That is, ano ba yung PC? Pressure at C. What is the pressure at C? 13 PSI. 13 pound per inch squared. Times 144 inch squared every feet squared. Yan. Divide by yung density at C. That is 99.84. Pound per feet cube. Okay. Pound, pound, inch squared, inch squared, inch squared. Okay. May matirang isa. So, the height column for the final part will be 13 times 144 divided by 99.84. So, the answer is 18.75 feet. Yan. 18.75 feet. Okay? So, ganun lang yung kanyang solving. Hindi talaga abot sa dulo yung height column niya. Nakadepende yan. Okay? 18.75. Okay? So, that is for your piezometry. So, I hope you are now ready to take the exam next meeting. Okay? So, continue on watching and then have your practice for pisometry. Okay. I think that will suffice for our meeting today. Bye-bye.